We are really excited to present this year's Western Colorado Chorale holiday concerts entitled Crystalline. And the idea is when a thought or the warmth of the holidays crystallizes in your mind, and we kind of expand that moment into the understanding of what this holiday season means for a lot of different people. So we have two pieces by Ola Gjeilo. One is Tundra, that illustrates his homeland, some of his favorite parts of Norway. And the other is The Rose, which talks about the rose from Jesse's stem, the allegory to the infant Jesus during this Christmas season. They're both with string quartet and piano, and they are just incredible, wonderful, beautiful pieces of music. The anchor for these concerts is something I'm incredibly excited about. It's the Christmas cantata entitled Ballad of the Brown King by Margaret Bonds, with lyrics by Langston Hughes, written specifically for this cantata. They were friends. They finally met when Margaret Bonds went to live in New York and became part of the musical theater scene, and did a lot of composing and performing in New York in the 40s and the 50s. This work premiered on CBS, actually, in 1960, the first performance of this Christmas cantata, Ballad of the Brown King. And Hughes and Bonds worked together to create this multi-movement work, and each movement is in a different style. And a lot of them evoke music of African Americans, or styles that can be traced back to African Americans. Jazz in the second movement, a lot of syncopation throughout the entire work, but some calypso rhythms in another movement. And the whole thing talks about what if, we don't have firm proof, but it explores what if one of these kings, at least, was probably, to use words from the cantata, brown like me, who was brown-skinned, who was of darker African descent. And so all of the movement's works talk about, center on the infant Christ, but also center on this one king who was probably from Africa. And Margaret Bonds, we are lucky to have this piece to perform. It is out of print. We rented the scores and the parts for this piece. And interestingly, Margaret Bonds' music, a big box of it was found next to a dumpster getting ready to thrown out after a garage sale. Her music spread far and wide after her death, because she died 4 years before the Copyright Act of 1976, and had one child but no heirs and no will. And her child died in 2011 with also no heirs and no will. So the copyright for her music is tricky. It doesn't get performed often as a result, but this is the first performance of her full original orchestration of this work that we know of in the state of Colorado or even in the region. And there are no official recordings that exist of this full orchestration either, probably due to the nebulous copyright issues that surround her works and their performance and recordings. But she faced racism in her life very growing up, obviously, but very in a very tangible way when she wanted to attend Northwestern University. A very talented musician she was, and in 1934 she was allowed to enroll, but could not use any of the services or facilities otherwise at Northwestern University. She was not allowed to live on campus. African Americans were not allowed to use the pool on campus at this time, and she talked a lot about facing discrimination both as a woman and as a woman of color, and talked about, you know, if a woman is born with talent, she's expected to do all of the things the traditional, you know, the traditional wife and woman was meant to do with the family, you know, back in the, actually not that long ago, these assumptions existed. But also then, if she wanted to have a professional career, she had to work 24 hours a day, is what she said. And she was right, and it really was and still is unfair in a lot of ways. So Margaret Bonds is a really inspirational figure, and this music is very inspired music. And it will be the first time anyone in this region has heard a live performance of her music. And this Ballad of the Brown King is considered by many to be her her greatest achievement, and she set out to orchestrate it as a masterwork to prove that she could do, that American music could be really, really wonderful and espouse American musical ideals. So we really hope that you come and join us December 18th and 19th, December 18th at 7:30 p.m., December 19th at 2 p.m. at Colorado Mesa University's Love Recital Hall for performances of Margaret Bond's The Ballad of the Brown King, surrounded by some other really wonderful holiday music.